Who you gonna call? Juan Buster! Or I should say Weed Buster.
What is going on, YouTube Nation? This is George with Princess Cuts, and I'm here with none other than Jeff Morrow, the Sandwich King. You may have seen him on Food Network, starring in the show The Kitchen. Jeff, what's going on,
man? How you doing, George? Thank you for accepting my call.
Oh, no problem, bud.
It's been a rough summer. I have been, most like most people, at home, right? Stuck in their houses, and when summer finally came, now I got to see the grass grow, and I was obsessed with how my lawn looked in the grass, and I am unhappy. So I'm a fan of yours. I've been learning, but I haven't applied anything yet. So I just needed, and I knew you were in the area, so I contacted you and you came a calling.
You know what? I'm taking a look at your lawn and it doesn't look too bad, but I think there's some things that we can do to it to make it look better.
I'll take that as a compliment. I've done nothing. I don't even mow it myself. You're not gonna make me mow it myself, are you?
No.
Okay. So I see that fancy mower of yours. I don't think I got space for that.
Hey, you know, maybe we could get into real mowing one day, but let's take baby steps for right now.
Please.
All right, Jeff, so tell me about a few of the problems that you're having.
But it's just, to me, it's so uneven, and there's all these little white flowers and little thistly things, and there's like, what I'm looking at is all the non-grass in my grass, you know what I mean? And it's driving me crazy. Brown patches, uneven color, all this stuff. And then I walk by some of these neighbors with this like verdant green, even, beautiful, lush grass, and I am, guess what, jealous. I have lawn envy, and I don't like lawn envy. It makes me feel inferior.
Well, I'll be honest, I'm taking a look at your neighborhood, and it looks like everyone's in competition around here for their lawns.
Really?
Yeah.
Are you going to sweep? You're going to mop up here. Is that why you came here? Because you go, I know that neighborhood. No bueno.
Yeah, I never seen more green lawns in my life, so we got to make sure we keep you up to the Joneses.
It's either shit or get off the pot right now. Right, we're in the end of June, and I need to do something so I can enjoy a couple months of good grass.
All right, cool. Well, let's take a look at what you got. So after inspecting your lawn, Jeff, I see that you actually have a problem with clover. And believe it or not, clover is actually not an invasive weed that you have to worry about too much, although it could definitely be unsightly.
That's what you know what? Invasive, non-invasive. It's unsightly, and I don't want it anymore. Is there hope for me? Can we safely remove that clover?
We'll tell you what. We're about to actually get rid of this clover today.
Thank you.
I had a feeling that you might have had an issue with this, so I brought something today that we can actually put down and kill it.
George's killer clover remover.
Sure. I'm going to teach you how to spray some weed control.
This is very exciting for me. I've seen these puppies. I've always wanted to strap one on.
All right, so the first product that we got here, it's a generic chickweed, clover, and oxalis killer.
Oxalis, chickweed, and clover. That is fun. That's why we're wearing these gloves, right? And we're far away from any cooking surfaces.
Exactly.
So this is my new scientific mad science area right here.
With the current climate of things, we want to make sure that we wear the proper PPE outside and inside.
This guy. So sensitive.
And then also, I got some surfactant. If you don't know what this is pretty much what sticks the weed control onto the weeds. So if you just spray it alone, the water droplets will fall off, but this will actually make it kind of a sticker.
Really?
Yeah. And then since you're a beginner, we're gonna use some of this blue dye.
I saw that on your channel. That's where you know where you're spraying.
Yeah.
Because otherwise, right, I've done the in the hose things.
Yeah.
Sometimes you don't know, have I been lingering on the section too long? Exactly. Have I neglected this section? This makes it totally clear.
Jeff called me last night. He's like, hey, I just sprayed down some nitrogen. I was like, are you sure you did it correctly?
And no, that's a very hard unsure.
All right.
I was very not much unsure. I think I thought I killed my lawn, so that's why I called you. I was very nervous.
So the first thing that I want to talk to you about is measuring. The label is the law.
Can't go, you can't improvise with this, right? Like if I put 2 tablespoons in there and it calls for 1, it's not going to make my grass twice as better.
No, definitely not. It's kind of a
that's not, but that's how I think, especially with cooking, more fat, right? It's going to taste better, but not in this case. Yes. So this is like baking, right? Where baking is a science, right? Of the world of, you know, a culinaria where you have to follow the baking recipe to a T, whereas cooking, it's a little more, more jazz.
I like that metaphor, how you incorporate it from the cooking world into the lawn world.
Branding.
Don't forget, check them out on Food Network.
ComeOnOver.com to listen to my podcast too.
Oh, nice.
Please.
Yes.
I want good lawn care specialists there to listen to it.
The label calls for 1 fluid ounce per gallon of water.
Got it.
And on the label, it says that 1 gallon of water covers 200 square feet. Since we have isolated weeds, we're gonna go ahead and apply it at 1 gallon for your whole lawn. We have some of your fancy utensils
there. Yes, these are very nice. I'm gonna hold this. Goes right in there.
Yep.
I rarely cook while sitting down. It's like the B.B. King style of blues guitar. You know, he only sat towards the later years. That's how we are right now. We're just two old men sitting while cooking.
Well, maybe me and B.B. King have a lot in common.
You're both kings of the lawn. All right, what's next?
All right, so we got the surfactant, so just throw a splash in there.
All right, this is something we don't have to be. Boom, splash.
That's good. Perfect.
Surfactant. Is that how you say it?
Surfactant.
Whoa!
And then the blue dye, you know, you also don't have to be too in depth with how much.
This is more for coloring, so we know where we're spraying. See,
this is for the noobs.
This is for the noobs, aka me. So do they have other colors of dye we can use, like mauve, pink, chartreuse?
Well, they also make a green one, but don't get any sneaky ideas because you can't use it to color your lawn. Or can you? Some people do. Now that you finished your first application, what are your thoughts?
I think it's a gratifying thing to do, just to squeeze it and feel the power. I'm happy it's one, I think it's already dry, and that's minutes later, so that's good for my dogs, right? And the kids running around. This is safe for the dogs, right?
Oh yes, absolutely. I mean, once you spray it, you just wanna make sure that it fully dries. And it'll be safe to walk.
Good. It's hot anyway. I want to keep them inside. But it was fun, and I feel like for the first time this summer, I've made progress, and I've addressed a situation smartly and from a scientific standpoint, too, which I just think I was just putting stuff on there willy-nilly. But I also want to get into the mowers, the short mowers.
Oh, the real mowers?
The real mowers, yeah. I've been watching those on the video. And my goal by next year, right, baby steps, like you said, I want that putting green grass here.
Oh man, well you know what? That's definitely gonna be a project all on its own. I'm taking a look at your lawn, it needs a little bit of leveling, but I think that you can get there pretty easily.
Leveling?
Yeah.
What?
When I say leveling, I mean multiple tons of sand.
We'll attack that next year.
You know what? I think you're gonna have the perfect lawn. So with that, this is George from Princess Cuts.
Check out comeonover.com to download my podcast. And watch The Kitchens every Saturday, 10 a.m. Central, 11 a.m. Eastern on Food Network.